Hello dear students, welcome to online CET class for NEET and Karnataka CET. And in this video I am discussing some multiple choice questions on body fluids and circulation with reference to NCERT exemplar and past year MCQs. Apart from that, some MCQs I have selected based on NCERT syllabus for both NEET and Karnataka CET. So let us move to the questions. Which of the following cells do not exhibit phagocytic activity? What is the meaning of phagocytic activity? Engulfing of entire substance or engulfing entire solid is called phagocytosis, and the given options are monocytes, neutrophil, basophil and macrophage. The phagocytic activity which is not shown, or the cell which do not exhibit phagocytic activity, is nothing but basophil. All these are the different types of WBCs present in the blood, and basophils do not exhibit phagocytic activity, and they belong to the group of the common granulocyte which are present in the blood. One of the common symptoms observed in people infected with dengue fever, idu bahala common aagi ellarigu gottiruvantadde, डेंगू फीवर बंदागा यावदु कॉमन सिम्टम ना नोड़तीवी. विच वन इज द कॉमन सिम्टम ऑब्जर्व्ड इन द पीपल इन्फेक्टेड विथ डेंगू फीवर. सो डेंगू फीवर बंदागा द मेन सिम्टम ऑब्जर्व्ड इज सिग्निफिकेंट डिक्रीज इन द प्लेटलेट काउंट. केळिरबहुदु मोस्टली ब्लड ना सेपरेट माड्तार, ब्लड ओळगिरो सेल्स ना सेपरेट माडी बरी प्लेटलेट पेशेंट के हाक्तर. सो प्लेटलेट नंबर डिक्रीजस् इफ द इंडिविजुअल इज इन्फेक्टेड विथ डेंगू फीवर. सो द राइट आंसर फॉर दिस वन इज ऑप्शन सी. देन मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट वन. विच अमंग द फॉलोइंग इज इनकरेक्ट ड्यूरिंग कार्डियक साइकल. व्हाट इज दैट कार्डियक साइकल? द कार्डियक साइकल इंक्लूड्स three important steps. One is joint diastole and another is the atrial systole and ventricular systole. ee mooru serisidre adane enantu karidara cardiac cycle an karidara. So one cardiac cycle lige the time required to complete the cardiac cycle is nothing but 0.8 seconds. So this one I explained in the synopsis part. I don't know whether you have observed that video or not. If you have not observed, go through the video for the clear theoretical solutions. So one cardiac cycle. So one cardiac cycle is represented by joint diastole. And the time taken for this one is 0.4 seconds. Another is atrial systole, that means contraction. Atrial is nothing but auricles, auricular systole. And the time taken will be 0.1 second because auricles are smaller chambers than that of the ventricles. Sannu irutava. Then the one more is ventricular systole. So ventricular systole takes 0.3 seconds. Systole means contraction, diastole means relaxation. So when ventricular systole occurs, the maximum amount of blood rushes into the blood vessels. But illi en kelidada question valga, which among the following is incorrect during each cardiac cycle? The volume of blood pumped out by the right and left ventricles is the same. The volume of blood pumped out by right and left ventricles is different. The volume of blood received by each atrium is different. The volume of the blood received by the aorta and pulmonary artery is different. Then which one is the correct answer? During cardiac cycle, remember the blood which is pumped out by the right and left ventricles is the same amount. This is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. Illa innondu neevu nenpidkobeku. What happens if the different amount of blood is pumped by the left and right ventricle? Here I will mention, if different volume of blood is pumped out by right and left ventricles result in heart failure. ಆ ಮನುಷ್ಯನಿಗೆ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಫೇಲ್ಯೂರ್ ಆಗೋ ಚಾನ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಇಫ್ ದ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಂಪ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್. ಎರಡೂ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಗಳು ಒಂದೇ ಸಾರಿಗೆ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತವ, ಎರಡೂ ಆರಿಕಲ್ಸು ಒಂದೇ ಸಾರಿಗೆ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತವ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈ ರಿದಮಿಕ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋ ಇಂಪಲ್ಸಸ್ಸನ್ನು ಸ್ಯಾನ್ ಜನರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಎರಡೂ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಸೇಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ಡು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಆದಾಗ ಅಥವಾ ಪಂಪ್ ಆದಾಗ ಮಾತ್ರ ದೆರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್, ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಫೇಲ್ಯೂರ್. ದೆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಮಾಡರೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಅಟನಾಮಸ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ನ್ಯೂರಲ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಲ್ ಅಂತ ಆಗಿದೆ, ನ್ಯೂರಲ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಟಿಕ್ ದ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿನ ಸಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಟರ್ಮ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ನ್ಯೂರೋಜೆನಿಕ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮಯೋಜೆನಿಕ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಯೋಜೆನಿಕ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್? ಇನ್ ಮಯೋಜೆನಿಕ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ದ ಇಂಪಲ್ಸಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಬೀಟ್ ಆರ್ ಜನರೇಟೆಡ್ ವಿಥಿನ್ ದ ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಮಸಲ್ಸ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಮು ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಂಪಲ್ಸಸ್ಗೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಬೀಟ್ ಆಗೋಕ್ಕೆ ಮೆಸೇಜ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಕೊಡಲ್ಲ. ಇಲ್ಲೇನು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಇದೆ, ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಮಾಡರೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಅಟನಾಮಸ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಟಿಕ್ ದ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಅದು ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿನ ಯಾವುದು ಇನ್ಫ್ಲೂಯೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ, ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಇನ್ಫ್ಲೂಯೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ದ ಸಿಂಪಥೆಟಿಕ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಸ್ಟಿಮ್ಯುಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ರೇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್? ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಪಂಪ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸ್. ಎರಡು ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಗಳು, ಸಿಂಪಥೆಟಿಕ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸಿಂಪಥೆಟಿಕ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಸಿಂಪಥೆಟಿಕ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮು ಎಕ್ಸೈಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ, ಅಂದರೆ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ರೇಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ, ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಟರಿ ರೇಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ, ಸ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮನ್ನು ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸಿಂಪಥೆಟಿಕ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಇಟ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಂಪಥೆಟಿಕ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಸೊ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಿ. ದೆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್. ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ದ ಪೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟನ್ಸಸ್ ಅಮಂಗ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋವಿಂಗ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಸೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕೋಆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಕೋಆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್? ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಕೋಆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಕ್ಲಾಟಿಂಗ್. ರಕ್ತ ಹೆಪ್ಪುಗಟ್ಟುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಕೋಆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಹಿಪ್ಯಾರಿನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಶಿಯಂ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್. ಹಿಪ್ಯಾರಿನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಂಟಿ ಕೋಆಗ್ಯುಲೆಂಟ್, ಅಂದರೆ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಹೆಪ್ಪುಗಟ್ಲಾರ್ದಂಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರಿವೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಕೋಆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಪ್ಯಾರಿನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಂಟಿ ಕೋಆಗ್ಯುಲೆಂಟ್. ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಶಿಯಂ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್, ಆಕ್ಸಲೇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೈಟ್ರೇಟ್, ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿಪ್ಯಾರಿನ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್? ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಕ್ಲಾಟಿಂಗ್ಗೆ ಕ್ಯಾಸ್ಕೇಡ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತದೆ. ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಒನ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟ್ ಆದಂಥ ಮೊಲೆಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಗಳು ಮತ್ತೊಂದರದ ಆಕ್ಟಿವೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾವ. ಸೊ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಶಿಯಂ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್. ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಯಾವುದಿಲ್ಲೇ? ಥ್ರೋಂಬೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿನ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ ಬೋತ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಶಿಯಂ ಅಯಾನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಥ್ರೋಂಬೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿನ್. ದ ಥ್ರೋಂಬೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್. ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಇನ್ ರೈಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಕೆಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರಿಗೆ ಥ್ರೋಂಬೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀಬೇಕು. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಥ್ರೋಂಬೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿನ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಹಿಪಾರಿನ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ರೈಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಹಿಪಾರಿನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಂಟಿ ಕೋಆಗ್ಯುಲೆಂಟ್. ಎಂಟಿ ಕೋಆಗ್ಯುಲೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರಿವೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಕೋಆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಕರೀತಾರ? ಥ್ರೋಂಬೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿನ್. ಈ ಥ್ರೋಂಬೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿನ್ ಬರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ದೆರ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಕ್ಲಾಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಜೋರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್, ಅ ಫಾಸ್ಫೋಲಿಪಿಡ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಥ್ರೋಂಬೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿನ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟು, ECG depicts the depolarization and repolarization process during the cardiac cycle. In the ECG of a normal healthy individual, one of the following waves is not represented. What are the waves of ECG? ಏನೇನು ಇರ್ತಾವ ECG ಒಳಗೆ? If you remember ECG properly, you can answer this question easily. So in ECG of a healthy person, the first wave is P wave, then the second wave is QRS complex, this is Q, and this is R, this is S, and this is T wave. So here P represents atrial depolarization. Atrial depolarization is represented by P wave, and QRS complex, adu muru kurse helbeku, the QRS complex represents ventricular depolarization, and T wave represents the repolarization of ventricles. Repolarization of ventricles. So compare madre. P atrial depolarization, QRS ventricular depolarization, T repolarization of the ventricles. Atria depolarize aagiddu matra torshedu. Atriumu ರೀಪೊಲರೈಸ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದನ್ನು ಯಾವುದೂ ECG ಒಳಗೆ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಹೆಲ್ದಿ ಪರ್ಸನ್ದು ECG ಒಳಗೆ ಏನು ಇರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಒಳಗೆ. ಸೊ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ರೀಪೊಲರೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಏಟ್ರಿಯಾ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಶೋನ್ ಇನ್ ECG ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಹೆಲ್ದಿ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್. ಸೊ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ರೀಪೊಲರೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿಪೊಲರೈಸೇಷನ್ ಎರಡೂ ಇರ್ತಾವ. But atrial repolarization is not shown in the ECG of any person. Then moving to the next one. Which of the following type of cells lack the nucleus? The direct answer, but ille, A option RBC, B is neutrophils, C is eosinophils, and D is erythrocytes. Another name of RBC is erythrocyte, but generally ether the option bandaga the RBC mark madri, erythrocyte mark madidru correct tappilla, but RBC itself is known as erythrocytes. So RBCs are enucleated. RBC maturity bandaga, the completely developed RBCs in mammals lack the nucleus, so the option is RBC. Which one of the following blood cells is involved in antibody production? This you have studied in the topic human health and diseases. So antibody production is the characteristic feature of B lymphocytes. So which B lymphocyte cell produces the antibody? Adannu nenpittukobeku. The plasma B lymphocytes are the cells involved in the production of antibodies. In the B lymphocytes, the group of the B lymphocytes called plasma B lymphocytes, they are the cells involved in the production of antibodies. They produce the antibodies, and these antibody molecules have Y-shaped structure, and the connection between heavy chain and light chain, heavy chain and light chain, is produced with the help of disulfide bond. The shape of the antibody molecule is Y-shaped structure. Then moving to the next question. The cardiac impulse is initiated and conducted further up to ventricles. The correct sequence of conduction of impulses is, so cardiac impulses message for the contraction and expansion or relaxation of the heart chambers is generated by SAN. Where it is located? The conducting system. The conducting system of heart consists of following structure. This is the right atrium. Here SAN is located. The SAN is also called pacemaker, and this generates the impulses, and these impulses are carried to the AVN, atrioventricular node, and from AVN the impulses are carried to bundle of His. This bundle of His undergoes branching. This one is left bundle branch, then this represents right bundle branch, and finally both the bundle branches produces thick fibers known as Purkinje fibers. And Purkinje fibers, if this is, let me show, this is SAN. From SAN impulses are carried to the, which one this is? AVN. From AVN impulse is carried to bundle of His. This is right bundle branch, and this one is left bundle branch. And finally from these bundle branches the thick fibers are produced. They spread throughout the wall of ventricles, and these fibers represents Purkinje fiber. So this is the conducting system of heart to carry the impulses necessary for rhythmic contraction and expansion or relaxation of the heart chambers. So yavudu aagtadille correct SA node, AV bundle and Purkinje fibers. So the right option for this one is option C. Then moving to the next one. Agranulocytes responsible for immune response of the body are, agranulocyte irbeku but body ge immune response anna kodbeku, so that is given by lymphocytes. Lymphocytes are the special cells which are responsible for providing immunity to the body. It may be B lymphocyte or it may be T lymphocyte. Then moving to the next one. The second heart sound dub is associated with the closure of lub and dub. Yared sound galu serisidre ondu heartbeat aagtada. A dub anu soundu yavaga produce aagtada. The dub sound is produced when the semilunar valves are closed. And one more thing you need to remember, the heart sounds are produced only due to the closing of valves. Heart valve close aadaga matra sound bartada. Avu open aadaga sound barudilla. There are two heart sounds. Heart sounds are of two types. The first sound is lub and second sound is dub. And first sound is produced when the AV valves are closed. What are these AV valves? AV valves are nothing but a tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve. ಈ ಬೈಕಸ್ಪಿಡ್ ವಾಲ್ವಿಗೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹೆಸರು ಏನಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಮಿಟ್ರಲ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ದ ಬೈಕಸ್ಪಿಡ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮಿಟ್ರಲ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸೌಂಡ್ ಡಬ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಸೆಮಿ ಲೂನಾರ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಸೆಮಿ ಲೂನಾರ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆದಾಗ ಈ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸೌಂಡು ಡಬ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಬೀಟನ್ನ ಕೇಳೋಕೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೂಮೆಂಟಿಗೆ ಸ್ಟೆಥೋಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ದೆನ್ ಎವಿ ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾರಣ ಏನು ವೆನ್ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ವೆನ್ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟೋಲ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟೋಲ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆದಾಗ ಏನು ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆಗ್ತವ ಎವಿ ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಎವಿ ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆಗ್ತವ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಮಿ ಲೂನಾರ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಓಪನ್ಡ್ ಸೆಮಿ ಲೂನಾರ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಓಪನ್ ಆಗ್ತವ ಎವಿ ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆಗ್ತವ ಯಾವಾಗ ವೆನ್ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸಿಸ್ಟೋಲಿಕ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಆಗಿ ವೆನ್ ಏಟ್ರಿಯಾ ಏಟ್ರಿಯಾ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಆರಿಕಲ್ ಅವಾಗಲೇ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ವೆನ್ ಏಟ್ರಿಯಾ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟೋಲ್ ಏಟ್ರಿಯಾ ಸಿಸ್ಟೋಲಿಕ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಒಳಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ಉಲ್ಟಾ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಎ ವಿ ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಓಪನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಮಿ ಲೂನಾರ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಆರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆದಾಗ ಸೆಮಿ ಲೂನಾರ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಆರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆದಾಗ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಕರ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಆರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವೆನ್ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಎ ವಿ ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆದಾಗ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಂಪ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆಸಲ್ಸ್ ದ ಪಲ್ಮೋನರಿ ಆರ್ಟರಿ ಕ್ಯಾರೀಸ್ ದ ಡಿಆಕ್ಸಿಜನೇಟೆಡ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಟು ಲಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅವೋರ್ಟ ಕ್ಯಾರೀಸ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನೇಟೆಡ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಓಪನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೆಮಿಲೂನಾರ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಎವಿ ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಆರಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಓಪನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ರೈಕಸ್ಪಿಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬೈಕಸ್ಪಿಡ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಮಿಲೂನಾರ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಆ ಸೆಮಿಲೂನಾರ್ ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆದಾಗ ಬರೋ ಅಂಥ ಸೌಂಡಿಗೇನೆ ಡಬ್ ಅಂತ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಅದ ಅಥವಾ ಡಬ್ ಅಂತ ಸೌಂಡ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋವಿಂಗ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ಸ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಬಾರ್ ಇವೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಕ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಕಾರ್ಡಿಯೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಒಂದು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಕಾರ್ಡಿಯೋಗ್ರಾಮನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡಾಗ ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಕ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ದು ಯಾವ ಪಾರ್ಟು ಕರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ಈ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡೇದ ಅಂತ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ QRS complex indicates atrial contraction. Is it right? It is wrong. QRS complex indicates ventricular contraction. Time between S and T represents atrial systole. P wave indicate beginning of the ventricular contraction. Here, the one exact sentence or correct sentence is QRS complex indicates ventricular contraction. Therefore, the right answer for this one is option B. Then moving to the next question. Which of the following statement is incorrect? About the blood groups, the options are given. A person of O blood group has NTA and NTB antibodies in his blood plasma. This is correct statement. Yavudu wrong ada adana identify madri ant helidu. A person of B blood group can't donate blood to a person of A blood group because B blood group iravrige alle antigen B irthada antibody A irthada. A blood group iravrige antigen A irthada antibody B irthada. Same antigen and same antibody mix aadre it results in blood coagulation. So the person with B blood group cannot donate the blood to the person with A blood group. Blood group is designated on the basis of presence of antibodies in the blood plasma. A person of AB blood group is universal recipient. Theoretically, matra is statement correct. Ile yav statement wrong ada adanna identify madbeko. Blood group is designated on the basis of presence of antibodies in the blood plasma. Blood group na classify madoke bari antibody matra consider madala. The blood groups are classified on the basis of two factors. To classify or to identify blood group of a person, what are the two factors required? Blood group is decided on the basis of antigen on RBCs and antibody in the blood plasma. Eradu beko. Antibody in the plasma and antigen on RBC, both the factors decides the blood group. If the person's blood group is A, antigen on RBC is A and antibody present in the blood plasma is B. If the person's blood group is B, antigen on the surface of RBC is B and antibody present in the blood plasma is A. AB blood group, both A and B antigens are present. No antibodies in the blood plasma. No antibodies. Yav antibody nu irudilla. If the person's blood group is O, antigens are absent. Yav antigen nu RBC mel irudilla. But both A and B antibodies are present. Yeradu irthav. A and B antibodies are present in the blood plasma. And this becomes O blood group. Ille designated on the basis of bari antibodies and the matra kottuddada. Bari antibody vande idre blood group decide aagudilla. Alli innu ond en bek namge antigen which is present on the surface of RBC. That is the main point to identify or to classify the blood groups. Then next question. What would be the cardiac output of a person having 72 heartbeat per minute and a stroke volume of 50 ml. So cardiac output andre enu eshtu blood na ventricles pump madlikattava. Cardiac output is represented or determined by heart rate, that is number of heartbeat into stroke volume. One sari heartbeat ige eshtu volume of blood ventricles inda pump aagi horag barlikattada. Amount of blood pumped per heartbeat. Prati one sari heartbeat ige andre one lub barbeku, one dup barbeku. ಸೊ ಎರಡೂ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆದಾಗ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕತ್ತದ ಅವರೇ ಕೊಟ್ಟಾರಿಲ್ಲ ಎರಡೂ ತುರ್ನ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಬೀಟ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಈಸ್ 72 ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಒಂದು ಸಾರಿ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಂಪ್ಡ್ ಬಾಯ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಸಾರಿ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬೋತ್ ದ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಒಂದು ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಬೀಟಿಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬ್ಲಡ್ಡು ಪಂಪಾಗಿ ಹೊರಗೆ ಬರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕತ್ತದ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆನ್ ಆ್ಯನ್ ಎವರೇಜ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 50 ml ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಪರ್ ಬೀಟ್ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡಾಗ 0.08 ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಂಪ್ಡ್ ಬಾಯ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ ಮಿನಿಟ್ ಸೊ ಪರ್ ಮಿನಿಟ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಈಸ್ 0.0 ಲೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಬೀಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಬೀಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ 5.5 liter ಸೊ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ 5000 ml ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋವಿಂಗ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಕಾಲಮ್ 1 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ 2 ಲಿಂಫ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಏನು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಲಿಂಫ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಡ್ರೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ದ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಪಲ್ಮೋನರಿ ವೇನ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸೋ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಸಿ ಟು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ದ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋವಿಂಗ್ ಲಿಂಫ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಟು ಡ್ರೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ದ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಟು ದ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಪಲ್ಮೋನರಿ ವೇನ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೀಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನೇಟೆಡ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಟು ದ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಏಟ್ರಿಯಮ್ ಥ್ರೋಂಬೋಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಕ್ಲಾಟಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಕೋಆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ದೆನ್ ಲಿಂಫೋಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಇಮ್ಯೂನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಥ್ರೋಂಬೋಸೈಟ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಅನದರ್ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ಥ್ರೋಂಬೋಸೈಟಿಗೆ ಏನಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಸೊ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ನೇಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಥ್ರೋಂಬೋಸೈಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೋಆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಸೊ ಫೈನಲಿ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಿ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 3 ಫಾರ್ ಬಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 1 ಫಾರ್ ಸಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 4 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 2 ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಸಮ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ NCERT ಎಕ್ಸೆಂಪ್ಲಾರ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಸೊ ನೌ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ MCQs ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ನೀಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ AIPMT ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ನೀಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಬಂದಂಥ ಕೆಲವು ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡದ ಲೆಟಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಟು ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ದ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಯುಟಿಲಿಟಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ 2010 to 2019 ದ ಕ್ರಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಟು ವಿಚ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟರಿ ಪಾತ್ವೇ ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಬಲ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಈ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರುವಂಥದ್ದು ಸೊ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ ದ ಕಾಲಮ್ 1 ವಿತ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ 2 ಪಿ ವೇವ್ ಏನು ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ಪಿ ವೇವ್ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಪೋಲರೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಏಟ್ರಿಯಾ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಇಟ್ ದ ಪಿ ವೇವ್ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಡಿಪೋಲರೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಏಟ್ರಿಯಾ QRS ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಡಿಪೋಲರೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಟಿ ವೇವ್ ಡಿ ರೀಪೋಲರೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಟಿ ವೇವ್ ಭಾಳ ಬೇಗನೆ ಬಂತು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಕರೋನರಿ ಇಶ್ಚೀಮಿಯಾ ಅಂದರೆ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆಸಲ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಬ್ಲಾಕೇಜ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಇವನ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಅಥೆರೋಸ್ಕ್ಲಿರೋಸಿಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಾಕೇಜ್ ಆರ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆಸಲ್ ಕರೋನರಿ ಇಶ್ಚೀಮಿಯಾ ಸೊ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲದ So for P it is 4, for B it is 1, and for C it is 2, and for D it is the third one. Okay, so correct option for this one is option A. Then moving to the next question. What would be the heart rate of a person if the cardiac output is 5 liter, blood volume in the ventricle at the end of the diastole is 100 ml, at the end of ventricular systole 50 ml? ಒಬ್ಬ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಯ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಬೀಟು ಎಷ್ಟದ ಅಂತ ನೀವು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದದ ಪರ್ ಮಿನಿಟಿಗೆ. ಇಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಈಸ್ 5 ಲೀಟರ್, 5 ಲೀಟರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 5000 ml. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಓನ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಬರೀ ಡಿಟರ್ಮೈನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಮೈ ವಿ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್, this is for question number 2. The cardiac output kottiddu eshtada 5 liter or 5000 ml. The blood volume in ventricle, so blood volume in ventricles at the end of ಡಯಾಸ್ಟೋಲ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಒಳಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಎಮ್ ಎಲ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಅದ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ, 100 ml ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ರಿಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಒಳಗಿದ್ದಾಗ 100 ml ಅದ. ಈಗ ಅದೇ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸು ಸಿಸ್ಟೋಲಿಕ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟೋಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 50 ml. ಅಂದರೆ ಏನಾಯ್ತದು, ಸ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಪಂಪ್ ಆದಾಗ ವೆಂಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸಿಂದ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕತ್ತದ, ಸ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಡಯಾಸ್ಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಇದ್ದಾಗ 100 ml ಅದ, ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆದಾಗ 50 ml ಮಾತ್ರ ಬಂದದ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ನೂ 50 ml ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಉಳಿದದ, ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಒಳಗೇನೆ ಉಳ್ಕೊಂಡದ. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ 50 ml. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಪಂಪ್ಡ್ ಎಷ್ಟದ, 5000. ಸೊ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ 5000 ml ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ದ 50 ml ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಪಂಪ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕತ್ತದ ಇಂಟು ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ರೇಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ರೇಟ್ is equal to the 5000 divided by 50, that becomes 100 heartbeat per minute. So 100 heartbeat per minute, ಒಂದು ನಿಮಿಷಕ್ಕೆ 100 ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಬೀಟ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಆ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಯ ಹಾರ್ಟು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕತ್ತದ. ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋವಿಂಗ್. ಫೈಬ್ರಿನೋಜನ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಅಥವಾ ಎದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕು? Fibrinogen is required for blood clotting mechanism. Globulin is the defense mechanism, albumin for osmotic balance. Globulin, IG anta barithivi, that IG stands for immunoglobulin. Immunoglobulin, globulin is a protein of the blood and it is associated with the immune system. So which one is the right answer for this one? The option C is the right answer for the given question. And moving to the next one, once again it is match the following. Tricuspid valve, where it is located? The tricuspid valve is located between the right atrium and right ventricle. The tricuspid wall, right auricle and right ventricle ad madhya present irthada, this is the right mark. Bicuspid valve between the left atrium and left ventricle. Semilunar valve between right ventricle and pulmonary artery. So what is the right option for this one? Option A is the correct answer. Then moving to the next question. Adult human RBCs are enucleated. Which of the following statements is our most appropriate explanation for this feature? Adult human RBCs are enucleated. Enucleated andre adrolagu nucleus irudilla. Yaaku nucleus irudilla anlikke naalaku reason galanna illi kottiruvantadu. They do not need to reproduce. They are somatic cells. They do not metabolize. All their internal space is available for the use of oxygen transport. So, ee naalaku options olaga idu maatra correct ada. All their internal space is available for oxygen transport. Therefore, the correct answer is option D. Only fourth given statement is correct. Even in the RBC, not only the nucleus is absent. RBC valaga bari nucleus alla. Even RBCs do not contain any cell organelles. In RBCs, the nucleus, other cell organelles, are absent, and RBCs do not show any metabolic activities and multiplication. RBCs do not show any metabolic activity and multiplication. Enu madudilla, because adrolagiro ella space en fill maadkondirutada, it is with hemoglobin, and eshtu jaasti hemoglobin irutada ashtu oxygen transport maadlike help maadutada. Therefore, the right answer for this one is option D. Only fourth statement is correct. Then blood pressure in the pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery andre yavudu? It is the blood vessel which is arising from right ventricle. This is pulmonary artery. En madutada? The pulmonary artery is carrying deoxygenated blood to the lungs. Pulmonary artery deoxygenated blood na lungs ge carry madutada. Blood pressure in the pulmonary artery is same as that in the aorta, more than in the pulmonary veins, less than that in the vena cava. So the blood pressure in pulmonary artery is more than that in the pulmonary vein, because pulmonary artery valaga blood rush aagbekadra athwa flow aagbekadra ventricles contract aagbeku. Obviously ventricles contract aadaga more pressure will be there in the pulmonary artery. But pulmonary vein en maartava? Pulmonary veins are the blood vessels. They bring oxygenated blood from lungs. Oxygenated blood from lungs to left atrium athava auricle. Left auricle ig oxygenated blood anna tagond bartava. So hangagi pulmonary vein olaga salpa pressure kadimene irutada. What is the blood pressure present in pulmonary artery? Pulmonary artery olaga systolic pressure andra ventricles contract aadaga irohanta systolic pressure is 20 mmHg. It is less than 20 mmHg. 20 mmHg irutada, and this will be the pressure. 20 mmHg vare irabodu athwa less andre eshtu irutada antandre 12 mmHg. This is the last value for the systolic pressure in the pulmonary artery. Then moving to the next question. Reduction in pH of blood will reduce the rate of heartbeat, reduce the blood supply to the brain, decrease the affinity of hemoglobin with oxygen, release bicarbonate ions by the liver. Nenpitukobeku, reduction of pH andre H plus ion concentration kadimakkot hoitu antandra en aagtada, it results in decreased in the affinity of hemoglobin with oxygen. Oxygen nu hemoglobin jotege bind ago affinity na reduce madkot hoktada. If the pH of the blood reduces, because it favors the dissociation, high pH iddaga oxyhemoglobin dissociate aglikke andre oxygen hemoglobin separate aglikke help madutada, but low pH ittu antandra affinity of the oxygen binding capacity with the hemoglobin decreases. If the pH is high, this favors the dissociation of oxyhemoglobin. Then moving to the next one, which one of the following animals has two separate circulatory pathway? Andre double circulation illi clear aagi elli nodtivi, lizard, it is reptile. So reptiles valada three chambered heart, incomplete double circulation. Shark, two chambered heart. Frog, amphibian, three chambered heart. Whale is a mammal, and all the mammals show the complete double circulation. The next one, blood pressure in the mammalian aorta is maximum yavaga? Diastole of the left ventricle, systole of the left ventricle, diastole of the right atrium, and systole of the left atrium. Aorta valage highest blood pressure na navu nodbeku antandra, it is possible only when the systole of the left ventricle occur. When the left ventricle contract, it results in maximum exertion of the blood pressure during the ventricular contraction. Therefore, the right answer is option B. Then moving to the next one, doctors use stethoscope to hear the sounds produced during each cardiac cycle. The second sound is heard when? Avagle discuss maadtu. Heart sound anna keloke doctors stethoscope anna use maadtar. Ee eradane sound of the heart beat yavudu? Dub. Yavaga produce aagtada? The dub is produced when the semilunar valves are closed. The closing of the semilunar valve after the blood flows into vessels from the ventricle, this one is sufficient. Semilunar valves close adaga, it result in the production of the second heart sound. First anth kelidra closing of AV valve answer aagtittu, but eradane sound dub produce aagbekadra alle semilunar valves close aagbeku. Erythropoiesis starts in, what is that erythropoiesis? Erythropoiesis is nothing but the formation of RBCs. RBC production ige erythropoiesis anta karitara. And remember, red bone marrow is the site where the RBCs are produced, and the right answer for this one is the option C, erythropoietin. With the help of this component, the red blood cells are produced in the red bone marrow. Process is known as erythropoiesis. Then, which one of the following is correct? Ile yavudu correct agi represent madlikattada? Option C is the only one. Blood represents the mixture of plasma, RBCs and WBCs. Platelet to kodbekittu, but kotta options valige suitable yavudada? The right option is option C. Then moving to the next question, how do parasympathetic neural signals affect the working of heart? Idrkinta munche vand bantu, sympathetic nervous system heart rate anna increase maadutada, stroke volume anna increase maadutada, even respiratory rate annu increase maadutada ant helide. But ille parasympathetic nervous system, it is functioning opposite to that of sympathetic nervous system. Sympathetic nervous system heart rate na, stroke volume na, cardiac output na increase maadidre, parasympathetic nervous system reduce both heart rate and cardiac output. So the right answer for this one is option A. Figure shown schematic plane of the plan of blood circulation in the humans with the labels A to D. Identify the label and gives its function. Ille A to D kelvand part galanna mark madkovatu hogittada. So D becomes pulmonary artery. Ekandre heart in the blood na direction nodri arrow mark na heart in the blood na lungs ik tokond hogligattada. A lungs in the blood na heart ik tarlikattada. So A is pulmonary vein and C is the vena cava, which is bringing the blood from body parts to the heart, and B is aorta. So nalak blood vessel galu enen function madlikattava anodu ille option valag mark madiddu. So let us write the blood vessels so that it is easy to identify the correct option. A is in the image, the given image, the A represents pulmonary vein. A is pulmonary vein. En madtada? It is bringing oxygenated blood from lungs to left atrium. Then B is aorta, and this brings oxygenated blood to body parts. Heart in the horagadek togond bartada. Then C is vena cava. It is carrying the deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood andra oxygen kadim irutada. And D is pulmonary artery. This is also bringing the deoxygenated blood to the lungs from heart. Heart in the togond barligatada. So enenada? B pulmonary artery anto agangla. D dorsal aorta alve alla yakandre adu pulmonary artery ada. A is pulmonary vein. It takes impure blood anta mention madada, but that is bringing pure blood. So one day one correct option yavudille B. Vena cava takes blood from the body parts to right auricle athwa atrium, and partial pressure of CO2 is 45 mmHg. So partial pressure 45 anta torislikatre, it is the indication the blood is rich in carbon dioxide, that is nothing but deoxygenated blood. So apart from this one, now I am going to discuss some additional questions with reference to NCERT. Hope the explained part or discussed questions is clear for you. Thank you. Hello dear students, welcome to online CET class for NEET and Karnataka CET. In this video, I am going to discuss some multiple choice questions on the human physiology topic, body fluids and circulation. So let us move to the questions. Here is the first one. Which of the following set of animals has an incomplete double circulation? So what is the reason for incomplete double circulation, or when the incomplete double circulation occurs? There are two terms, complete double circulation and incomplete double circulation. So one is complete double circulation and another is incomplete double circulation. The complete double circulation occurs only when heart consists of four chambers. So heart consists of four chambers, then only the complete double circulation is possible. So when heart consists of three chambers, so heart with three chambers, it shows the incomplete double circulation, and a three-chambered heart is character of all the amphibians and reptiles with the exception of which one? Crocodile. The crocodile is reptile, but it contains four-chambered heart. The four-chambered heart is present in the crocodile. So when heart is three-chambered, it consists of two auricles and only one ventricle is present. This is right auricle and this one is left auricle, and this is only ventricle and this is partially divided. This is the reason why the incomplete double circulation occurs. So in the given option, both the animals having incomplete double circulatory system are nothing but has. What is that nodal tissue where it is present? The nodal tissue is the special cardiac tissue present in the heart. It is responsible for generation and conduction of impulses necessary for the rhythmic functioning of the heart chambers. So that is contraction and relaxation, systolic condition and diastolic condition. The conducting tissue of human heart consists of many parts such as SAN, sinoatrial node known as pacemaker, and it is located in the upper part of right auricle. SAN generates the impulses rhythmically. On an average, 70 to 75 impulses per minute. From SAN, the impulses are carried to one more conducting part, AVN, and from AVN, the impulses are carried to bundle of His. But AVN makes a delay of 0.3 seconds to transfer the impulses to bundle of His. Then question is, why that delay is carried out? As it receives the impulses from SAN, with the same time and same speed, AVN does not transfer the impulses to bundle of His. It makes a delay of 0.3 seconds. It is called AV nodal delay. This delay helps in the complete filling of the ventricles with the respective blood. That means right ventricle will be completely filled with deoxygenated blood, and the left ventricle will be completely filled with oxygenated blood, so that the complete filling of the ventricles is helped with the help of a delay of 0.3 seconds which is made by AVN. So once the impulses are received by bundle of His, the impulse carrying system branches here. This is left bundle branch and this one is
right bundle branch. So left bundle branch moves towards the left ventricle and right bundle branch moves towards the right ventricle. Finally, from these bundle branches, the thick fibers are produced and they are called Purkinje fibers. The name for these fibers is Purkinje fibers. And finally, the impulses given by the sac, they received by Purkinje fibers. Remember, the Purkinje fibers are surrounding or they are present only around the wall of ventricles. They do not cover the auricles. The Purkinje fibers cover the wall of ventricles, and the contraction of ventricles is finally supported with the impulses given by Purkinje fibers. Therefore, the nodal tissue musculature in human heart is nothing but Purkinje fibers throughout the ventricular musculature. These are the musculature nodal tissues present around both the ventricles. Then moving to the next one. During the joint diastole, what happens? Both atria relax but ventricles contract. Both ventricles relax but atria contract. Both semilunar valves are open. Tricuspid and bicuspid valves are open. What is this joint diastole? In the cardiac cycle, the three steps are explained, or one cardiac cycle is represented by three steps. Here I am writing the explanation for question number 3. So in cardiac cycle, the three steps are: one is joint diastole, another is auricular systole, and one more is ventricular systole. So these are the three steps with reference to the study of cardiac cycle. So joint diastole requires or takes 0.4 seconds of time, auricular systole 0.1 second and ventricular systole 0.3 seconds. Therefore, the time required for the completion of one cardiac cycle is 0.8 seconds and one cardiac cycle is equal to one heartbeat. So one heartbeat, that is lub and dub, that single heartbeat is equal to one cardiac cycle. What happens during the joint diastole? That you need to remember. During the joint diastole, both auricles or atria, that means right atrium and left atrium, and both ventricles are in the relaxed state. All the four chambers of heart are in the relaxed state so that the tricuspid and bicuspid valves are open. Where do you find this? The tricuspid valve is between right atrium and right ventricle, and bicuspid valve, mitral valve, is nothing but bicuspid valve. This is present between left atrium and left ventricle. When all the four chambers are in the relaxed condition, remember, the semilunar valves are closed. Semilunar valves are closed, but tricuspid and bicuspid valves are in the open condition so that drop by drop the blood flows from auricles into the ventricle. The blood from right atrium is flowing into the right ventricle and the blood from left atrium is flowing into the left ventricle. The blood flows from auricle into ventricle because both tricuspid and bicuspid valves are in the open condition. Therefore, what happens during joint diastole? All the four chambers of the heart are in the relaxed condition. Semilunar valves are in the closed condition. Tricuspid and bicuspid valves are partially opened, not completely opened, but that partial opening is helping in the flow of blood from right atrium into right ventricle and left atrium into left ventricle. So the right answer for this question is option 4. So this one is the correct answer. Mark the incorrect statement regarding normal ECG. Patient is connected to 3 electrical leads, one to each wrist and to the left ankle. T wave represents atrial repolarization. Q marks the beginning of ventricular systole and R represents the ventricular depolarization. What is that ECG? Electrocardiogram. Electrocardiograph is obtained. This is P wave. This is QRS complex. This is QRS complex. And here is the T wave. When a healthy person's ECG is observed, yes, Q represents the beginning of ventricular systole. That is why we will get the long wave here, because ventricular contraction takes for 0.3 seconds. And T wave, what is this? Here I said the QRS complex represents the ventricular contraction. That means the ventricles are in the polarized condition, depolarized condition. So when it reaches the T represents repolarization of the ventricle. But here, the one incorrect statement about the ECG is option 2. The T wave represents atrial repolarization. This is mentioned here. But it is not atrial repolarization. Actually, it is representing ventricular repolarization. So the right answer for this question is option 2. Then moving to the next one. Hepatic portal system carries. What is the meaning of hepatic portal system? Hepatica means liver. So, hepatic portal system is a special feature in case of vertebrates, especially in case of humans. And what is the function of hepatic portal system? The hepatic portal system carries deoxygenated blood from the intestine to liver. The deoxygenated blood from the intestine is carried to the liver with the help of hepatic portal system, and this represents the hepatic portal system. So hepatic portal system is carrying deoxygenated blood from where to where? From intestine to liver. Then coronary artery diseases, short form CAD, one of the problems of heart is often referred to as atherosclerosis. The diameter of the blood vessel or the lumen of the blood vessel decreases due to the deposition of cholesterol. Even due to the deposition of calcium, the lumen of the blood vessel decreases. It puts pressure on the pumping mechanism of the heart, and this is called the atherosclerosis, also known as coronary artery disease. Then moving to the next one. Fastest distribution of some injectable material or medicine and with no risk of any kind can be achieved by injecting into the, very interesting question. See, a patient is admitted in the hospital. Some urgent medicine or the injection is required to inject into the body of that patient. So where to inject? Whether it should be injected into the muscle, it should be injected into the arteries, it should be injected into the veins, or it should be injected into the lymph vessels. Remember, any kind of the medicine with no risk and it can be injected into the patient body, into the veins. What is the reason? Always the intravenous injections are given. So whenever the cannula, the thick needle which is inserted for the supply of either saline or any kind of the injection through the saline are injected, introduced into the body intravenously. That means it is injected through the vein only. Then question arises, why the veins are selected? Because veins are insensitive to the irritation by irritant drugs at higher concentration. Even though used drug is very irritable, but veins do not show any kind of the irritability for those irritant drugs. This is one reason. And second one, it is the fastest route for the distribution of drugs. Let me write the information so that you can remember the things more easily. Why the veins are selected for the injection purpose? So first thing, the veins are insensitive. First reason, veins are insensitive to the irritable drugs or to the irritation of drugs. Any kind of the irritation is caused by the drug, irritation of drugs. This is one reason. Then second reason, it is the fastest route. It is the fastest route for the distribution of drug, for the distribution of drug. That is why usually the veins are selected for the injection of the medicine during any kind of the medical treatment. Next one. Given below are four statements A to D regarding human blood circulatory system. Actually, I missed to add the options, and it is asked to identify which two statements are correct with reference to human blood circulatory system. Arteries are thick-walled and have narrow lumen as compared to the veins. Angina is acute chest pain when blood circulation to the brain is reduced. Person with blood group AB can donate blood to any person with any blood group under ABO system. Calcium ion play a very important role in blood clotting. Even that term is also missed. So what are the two statements which are correct among the given statements? So option or the statement one is, A is right statement. Arteries are thick walled as compared to the veins and have narrow lumen. Then D is also correct. A and D are the correct statements about human circulatory system. Why B and C are wrong? Angina is acute chest pain when blood circulation to the brain is reduced, not to the brain. Angina is nothing but a chest pain, and this is shown by the heart. If heart is not properly supplied with the oxygenated blood, in that case the acute chest pain is developed, which is called angina or angina pectoris. Person with blood group AB can donate blood to any person with any blood group under ABO system. This is also wrong. The person with AB blood group can receive the blood group from A, B and AB, AB and O. Therefore, AB blood group, theoretically it is called universal recipient. Universal recipient blood group is nothing but AB. It is not the universal donor. Theoretically only I am explaining. Universal donor is O blood group, universal recipient is AB blood group. So that B and C are the wrong statements. Then moving to the next question. Open type of blood vascular system is found in. What is that open type of blood vascular system? In open blood vascular system, when blood is pumped by the heart, it is released into the body cavity. It does not flow into the blood vessels. If blood pumped by the heart is released into the body cavity, that kind of the circulatory system is called open circulatory system, and it is present in cockroach. Insects are having, arthropods are having open type of blood vascular system. Then moving to the next question. Right systemic arc is absent in. What is that systemic arc? Before moving to the explanation, let us mark the right option, then I will go for the explanation. Right systemic arc is absent in mammals. Even it is absent in reptiles also, but in options the term reptile is not given, so the right option is mammals. If at all one more option is both mammal and reptile, then that will be the correct answer. So let us elaborate the term right systemic arc. What is that systemic arc? Systemic arc is nothing but it is a pair of blood vessels found in the tetrapods. Again, the terms are related to animal kingdom only. Which group of animals are called tetrapods? So tetrapods are nothing but animals having four limbs. What are those four limbs? Two are hind limbs and two are fore limbs. When hind limbs and fore limbs are present, they are called tetrapods. So tetrapod group includes amphibians are tetrapods, reptiles are also tetrapods, birds are also tetrapods, but in birds the hind limbs are modified forelimbs are modified into wings, and mammals are also tetrapods. So let me explain about the systemic arc. What is this systemic arc? Systemic arc is represented by a pair of blood vessels. A pair of the blood vessels where it is present, found in the embryo of tetrapods. It is found in the embryo of tetrapods. And what is its function? It carries the blood from aorta. The systemic arc carry blood from aorta. It is the function of the systemic arc. The systemic arc may be right systemic arc or it may be left systemic arc. So right systemic arc is present only in the birds. Here only I will mention the birds contain right systemic arc, and in case of reptiles is also given there. The right systemic arc is even absent. More than one is correct option here. The reptiles and mammals, both of them are having left systemic arc. So both of them are having left systemic arc. The right systemic arc is present in case of birds. So option actually both 1 and 3 becomes the right option. So both reptiles and mammals show the left systemic arc. It is completely absent in the mammals and reptiles. Physiology of blood circulation was first described by the double circulation process. It was first described by Sir William Harvey. This is the right option. Carl Landsteiner explained about ABO blood system in the humans. AB and O blood group system explained by or classified by Carl Landsteiner, whereas the double circulation or the physiology of blood circulation was first described by William Harvey. Then moving to the next question. Contraction of the heart of a frog commences from. Frog is characterized by three-chambered heart. It is belonging to amphibia. So which one gives the impulses for contraction of heart? From where it is originated? Right auricle, left auricle, interauricular septum and sinus venosus. In the frog, the incomplete double circulation is observed and the contraction of the heart of a frog commences from sinus venosus. Sinus venosus is nothing but it is compared to pacemaker of humans, or else in frog the sinus venosus represents pacemaker. So like our sinoatrial node, in frog the sinus venosus represents pacemaker, and this sinus venosus is nothing but an enlarged region where it is present. An enlarged region between vena cava and right auricle. Between the vena cava and right auricle, this is located. That means exactly in the right auricle only, as that of humans. But as the frog shows incomplete double circulation, this is referred as a sinus venosus, and it is representing the pacemaker in case of a frog. Then renal portal system is absent in. Actually, the options given here are wrong. The renal portal system is absent in. Here I am mentioning the answer only. The right answer is mammals. The renal portal system is absent in the mammals because mammals are having hepatic portal system. The hepatic portal system is present in the mammals and renal portal system is absent in the mammals. What is the function of renal portal system? It supplies the blood to renal tubules when glomerular filtration is absent. in the kidney, if glomerular filtration is absent, the blood is supplied to the renal tubules through the renal portal system. And remember, it is absent only in the mammals. Then, the pre-cable vein is formed of, interesting question, pre-cable vein. This is another name of superior vena cava. What is that superior vena cava? The superior vena cava is the blood vessel which opens into the right atrium, and this is collecting the deoxygenated blood from upper body parts. Superior vena cava and another is inferior vena cava. This is superior vena cava. This one is inferior vena cava. Both the vena cava open into right atrium. But what is the difference? Superior vena cava collects the deoxygenated blood from upper body parts. That means from above the diaphragm. Whatever the body part is present above the diaphragm, from all those body parts, the deoxygenated blood is collected with the help of superior vena cava and it is carried to the right atrium. Like that, inferior vena cava, this collects deoxygenated blood from the lower body parts. Lower body part means all the body parts which are present below the diaphragm. So below the diaphragm, the body parts are called lower body parts. Diaphragm antandra vape anta artha. Whatever the body part is present below the diaphragm, from those body parts, the deoxygenated blood is collected with the help of inferior vena cava, and from the upper body parts, it is collected through the superior vena cava. And remember, the pre-caval vein is another name of superior vena cava. Then what is another name for this one? Inferior vena cava is called post-caval vein. The post-caval vein is another name of inferior vena cava. And superior vena cava is another name of superior vena cava is also called pre-caval vein. This superior vena cava is made up of two important structures. One is external jugular and subclavian. These are the two parts, actually three parts are there. So external jugular, internal jugular and subclavian. These three structures together, let me write here one more, it is missed here. Internal jugular, external jugular, internal jugular and subclavian. These three structures together produce one blood vessel called superior vena cava, which collects the deoxygenated blood from all the upper body parts and it is carried to the right atrium. So let me inform one more thing. External jugular, this collects the blood from head. The external jugular is collecting, this is collecting blood from the head, from the head region, from tongue as well as from the muscles of jaw. From the muscles of jaw, the blood is collected by external jugular. And internal jugular, this collects the blood from muscles of neck and brain. The deoxygenated blood from muscles of neck and brain is collected with the help of internal jugular. Then subclavian jugular, It collects the deoxygenated blood from shoulders and forelimbs, that is hand. Shoulders and forelimbs, the deoxygenated blood from shoulders and forelimbs is collected with the help of subclavian. And these three together produce the superior vena cava, which is also known as the pre-caval vein, which opens into right atrium. Then moving to the next question. Cardiac cycle in man takes about, previously only discussed about this one. The total time taken for the cardiac cycle is 0.8 seconds. If more particular, if it is extended, in that 0.8 seconds, so the total time taken for cardiac cycle is 0.8 seconds. In that, joint diastole of all the heart chambers, four heart chambers, 0.4 seconds, atrial systole 0.1 second, then ventricular systole 0.3 seconds. So 4, 3 and 1, the total time taken for one cardiac cycle is 0.8 seconds. The pigment hemocyanin is found in hemoglobin hemocyanin. Remember, it is present in the members of mollusca. What is that hemocyanin? Hemocyanin is copper containing pigment. This contains copper. Copper containing pigment. What is present in the hemoglobin? Iron containing pigment is called hemoglobin, and copper containing pigment is called hemocyanin. One interesting fact about the hemocyanin that you should know, you must remember and you should know, the fact about hemocyanin is that when hemocyanin is deoxygenated, let us assume the hemocyanin or blood is subjected to deoxygenation. It is rich in carbon dioxide, deoxygenated, then the hemocyanin becomes colorless. In the deoxygenation condition, the hemocyanin is colorless. Hemocyanin becomes colorless, and contrary to this one, on oxygenation, once the oxygenation occurs, that means oxygen is supplied, it becomes blue colored. So blue color of the hemocyanin is produced when it is exposed to the oxygenation, and the same hemocyanin pigment becomes colorless when it is subjected to deoxygenation. And which mineral element is present in the hemocyanin? Answer is copper. Then moving to the next one. In mammals, the blood from right ventricles goes to, the answer is pulmonary arteries, not aorta. Let me correct this one. This is pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery is the correct option for this question. From right atrium, blood flows into right ventricle with the opening of tricuspid wall. From the base of right ventricle, the blood vessel arises. This is called pulmonary artery. Between right or ventricle and pulmonary artery, the wall present is called semilunar valve. The opening of the semilunar valve, it carries the blood from right ventricle through the pulmonary artery to the lungs for the purpose of oxygenation. So the right answer for this question is option 4. Contraction of ventricles in the heart begins by the command from which one is called pacemaker among the four given options? Purkinje fibers, AV node, chordate tendina, chordiae tendinae, and SA node. What is this chordiae tendinae? These are present at the base of ventricles in both right ventricle and left ventricle, and from them the muscles are attached to the base of tricuspid and bicuspid valve. They are responsible for opening of the tricuspid and bicuspid valve only in the downward direction, not in the opposite direction, or the outflow of the blood from right ventricle into atrium is never supported, and these structures are nothing but chordiae tendinae. Contraction for the ventricle in the heart is begin with the command given by SA node. Where it is located? It is located in the upper part of right atrium or auricle, and SA node is also known as pacemaker because it generates the impulses for rhythmic contraction and relaxation of the heart chambers. So the right answer for this question is option 4. Then moving to the next one. A muscular wall is absent in, again interesting question. A muscular wall is absent in venule, vein, arteriole and capillary. Where it is absent? The muscular wall, remember, it is absent only in the capillaries, because capillaries are the very minute branches of the arterioles, and they are made up of a single layer of squamous epithelium. Actually, arteries and veins, they are made up of three wall layers: tunica intima, tunica media and tunica externa. And this tunica media is having the muscular wall, but capillaries do not contain muscular wall. So let us mark this one. What are these capillaries? Actually, first, arteries. Arteries are blood vessels which carry the oxygenated blood, with the exception pulmonary artery. The branches of artery are called arterioles. The branches of the arteries are nothing but, these are arterioles, and arterioles become further minute, and these minute blood vessels are called capillary. So capillary is made up of only single layer of capillary is made up of single layer of squamous epithelium. Single layer of squamous epithelium is present in the capillary. An open circulatory system occurs in. So again, the same question. The open circulatory system is the character of insects, because when blood is pumped by the heart, it is released into body cavity. Therefore, type of the circulatory system is called open circulatory system. The heartbeat of a person increases at the time of an interview due to the secretion of. The answer is adrenaline. Let us elaborate The answer for 22nd question. What is this? Adrenaline is hormone always produced or secreted in stress. When a person is in the stress condition, the hormone is secreted from adrenal medulla. The adrenal gland is divided into two parts, adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. So adrenaline is a hormone of adrenal medulla, and this secretes the hormone adrenaline. So the hormone is secreted during the stress condition. It also increases the alertness. The adrenaline is responsible for increasing of alertness. Alertness of a person can be increased with the adrenaline secretion. Then, which layer of the wall of the blood vessel is made up of circular smooth muscle? Outer, inner, middle, both 1 and 2. And the answer for this one is middle layer. What is that middle layer? Actually, the complete name is tunica media. The tunica media is the middle layer, and this is made up of smooth muscles and elastic fibers. It is made up of smooth muscles and elastic fibers. Then this is the particular wall of the blood vessel and made up of smooth muscle and elastic fibers. Then moving to the next one. Which artery is absent in frog? Renal artery, carotid artery, phrenic artery, right systemic arch. Remember, the phrenic artery is absent in the frog. What is phrenic? Is there any idea about this one? Phrenic artery, it is the artery which carry the blood to diaphragm. What is a diaphragm? Diaphragm is a muscular layer that separates upper body part and lower body part. So phrenic artery, it carry blood to diaphragm. And in frog, the condition is that larva contains diaphragm, but it is reduced. Larva contains reduced diaphragm, and in adult frog, it is absent. In adult frog, the diaphragm is absent, and in the larva, the reduced diaphragm is present. So when a diaphragm is absent in the adult condition, there is no question or necessity of a phrenic artery. Then heart is simple, tubular and ventral in. The direct question with reference to the character of urochordata. So the answer for this one is urochordata. Then one more question. Blood pressure is measured by. The instrument used to measure the blood pressure is nothing but sphygmomanometer. This is the particular instrument used to measure the blood pressure in man, and it is known as a sphygmomanometer. So these are some questions that I wanted to discuss on the topic body fluid and circulation. So one more video you will get on the same topic, but that contains MCQs appeared in past year question papers. Hope the explained part is clear for you. Thank you.